In a world increasingly reliant on artificial intelligence, one question stands out. Can we trust AI to be fair in law enforcement? I am Rohan Jowallah, and today we're going to go deeper in the world of AI as it relates to AI bias and the quest for justice. Law enforcement agencies worldwide are turning to AI for help, from predicting crimes before they happen to identifying suspects in seconds. But how does this technology really work? Using vast data sets, AI can spot patterns invisible to the human eyes. But this power comes with great responsibility. Studies have revealed that AI in policing can lead to faster response time and more efficient resource allocation. Yet, this is just one side of the coin. But the question is, what happens when AI gets it wrong? Bias in AI is a reality. This could mean misidentifying a suspect or targeting certain communities unfairly. Even when victim reports are used to get more accurate pictures of crime, biases are present. For example, Black people are more likely to be reported for crime than white people. Additionally, communities' trust or distrust in the police affect how people report crime, leading to either over or underestimation of crime is, of course, a certainty. Let us examine one case where AI led to wrongful arrest. In January of 2020, Williams, an African-American man, was wrongly arrested in Detroit, Michigan, due to a false facial recognition match. In this situation, the AI-based facial recognition system used by the Detroit Police Department incorrectly matched Williams' driver's license photo with surveillance footage of someone shoplifting. Of course, Williams was arrested and charged. Williams was arrested at his home in front of his family and held in detention. He was released only after it became clear that he was not the person on the surveillance video. Traumatic indeed. Detecting bias in AI is challenging but not impossible. It involves scrutinizing the data and, of course, the algorithm within. And we have to take this into consideration. Therefore, the datasets on which these tools are designed must be critically reviewed to ensure that these forms of discrimination and, of course, problems are reduced. One thing we have to be mindful of is that as we navigate the world of technology, we must understand that everything is based on datasets, especially in the era of AI. And if these datasets are not enough or not adequate for the population which it seeks to serve, then it must, of course, go under heavy investigation. One thing is clear, as we move along the line of technology, we have to be cognizant that datasets are not pure. They have biases. And of course, these biases can lead to problems in our society. And that brings us to the point of the need to ensure that when we think about policing and the use of AI, we have to think of systems that will work. In one situation, a dataset that was used to track criminals in Canada was also applied to the United States, and this created a problem because what happens in another locality should not be applied to another locality. And another point that gets me, we think about crime in certain communities and we see black on black crime and so forth. But let us not forget that there's also crime in other areas, and I think that's important not to marginalize a set of individuals based on that. Because if we continue, then we will produce, of course, discriminatory and biased algorithms. As we've seen, bias in AI is not just a technical issue, but is a reflection of our social values. Detecting and addressing this bias is not just the work of scientists or engineers. It's a task for all of us. Let me say, by staying informed and demanding transparency and fairness, we can guide AI towards a just and equitable future. What are your thoughts on AI law enforcement? I want to share your comments below. And if you found this video enlightening, please like, share, and subscribe for more deeper dive in the era of AI and other topics. Let me say, I've always enjoyed sharing content. Please subscribe.